take you on a ride. Gotta go to the church and grab a few things. But the weird thing is I'm putting a camera in my dashboard. I don't know if it's gonna fall or not. I'm hoping not. It's not the church's camera, it's Shannon's, okay? It's been super weird, the fact that we haven't had any church in a while. Leaf blower. And I live in a neighborhood with like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get hit by this car. Okay. So I live in a neighborhood where there's construction happening constantly. With that comes nails and tires. So I get a nail in my tire like once every 2 to 3 months. I get to take it into the shop constantly. And they love me there. I have on the back of my Jeep right now is a tire with a nail in it. I thought the office was closed. Is it not closed? Can I film you giving us a tour of your office? Your new space?
There's nothing in there, bro.
What? Give us a
tour. This is going to be.
This is where I will do work.
In the corner, just crisscross up.
You guys on a beanbag chair. You have a really minimalistic kind of approach to your workspace.
That's all I need, just to make a floor, you know?
This is just a normal day for Dennis.
He
just get this. I like didn't want you to fall, but I kind of had like this like kind of hope, just like maybe he'll fall, he'll be okay. All right, so I'm so excited. I'm so excited for this book that we're jumping into in the Bible, the book of Ephesians. A guy named Paul, and he's actually writing a letter to the church of Ephesus all the way back in like 52 AD. And so he's writing this letter to the church, and this church is going kind of crazy. Maybe not necessarily the church fully, but definitely the city that they're in. The city of Ephesus was the third largest city in all of the Roman Empire. Their church was a pretty large church. I mean, it had a lot of influence and a lot of traffic and a lot of different types of people coming into the church. The first three chapters are all about what God has done for us. The second three chapters are all about how we should live because of it. I love this book because it really outlines those two things, our position in Christ, but then also how we should live because of it. And it's that order that I love so much. It's not about what we do to get God's approval. It's about the fact that we have God's approval. Now, what do we do because of it? It's an amazing, amazing feeling to know the freedom that there is in a relationship with Jesus, that I don't have to do anything to earn this position, but because I've been given them, because of the position God's given me, because of the forgiveness God's shown me, the grace He's shown me, everything needs to change in my life. And I love that this book is laid out that way. 1, 2, and 3, all about what He's done for us. 4, 5, and 6, all about how we should live for Him. This book has been transformative for my life, and I believe it's gonna be a big deal for you too. All right, so I have a small complaint. I can't handle it that so many different packaging for like food, oftentimes you can't find the expiration date anywhere. You would think like something so important would be like big on the wrapper. So I look at this and I'm like, okay, I'll just show you. Here we go. So here's some bread I found in the fridge, and I want to cook it. I want to toast it. I'm like looking for an expiration date anywhere, and I can't find it anywhere. And so I'm just gonna assume like we're good. The worst thing ever is eating bread and then looking and seeing mold in the bread. It's the worst thing ever. Will not have it today. I will have a good sandwich with no mold. Yeah. I think it looks good. I don't see any mold, so I think we're good. Okay, so I started weighing my food, and I don't know if I have a problem or not.
You do.
4.1, what'd you say?
You do have a problem.
Well, I'm weighing the food, and I don't know. I did it at first because we were doing some, like, diet stuff, but now it's like I have, like, OCD with it.
You don't meet criteria for OCD.
So this is what it's like having a counselor in the house. I'll say things, and it's actually not the correct terminology. Okay. So. So. That's me, like 10th grade, 9th grade, something like that. This was the first game of our JV season. It was a big deal to me in that time. Going into my freshman year of high school, I had moved to a brand new city and I wanted to play football. We go through all the rounds of cuts. There were over 200 kids that had tried out for this team. I get to the very last week of tryouts and guess what? My name gets called, I get cut. That can be humbling for sure. Like just the fact that I got cut from my JV football team was ridiculous. Maybe you've found yourself at some point in your life where you weren't picked at all. I think the amazing thing about the book of Ephesians is that it tells us that God picked us. That I know that God picked me. Because I know what it's like to not be picked in the smallest sense, maybe with my JV football team, but in so many different areas of my life, and maybe you can relate too. The reality is, God picked you. That's why I love this book. It's an amazing book all about how God picked you, and you didn't have to do anything to earn it. He just did it.